Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. Your host today is Jesper Pedersen. I'm trying to stretch this so that this episode isn't ending up being just 1 minute long, because what I'm going to show you is really fast shown. On the other hand, it will save you a ton of time if you haven't seen this trick before. So stay tuned. Okay, here goes. I have this amazing application with a main in it that calls FNG. F is calculating Fibonacci 50 a number of times and add all the results together. G just calls Fibonacci 5. What is up here? This is the peculiar Fibonacci. Well, that's your regular implementation of Fibonacci. Nothing amazing to see here. Let me just build this for you. That went pretty fast, didn't it? And it did build something, see? I am building something, so that's pretty good. Well, I'll tell you why it's so fast. That's because I use a compiler cache. I can tell you that in another episode. So I actually need a change in here for actually making it compile. And now I'm compiling. And you can see F was compiled pretty fast. G. And soon my fan will start up because my computer were thinking pretty fast. It claimed here 9 seconds in total to compile it all. Why is that? Well, it's this little word here, const expr. This is not a C++ lesson, but what this basically does is that it compiles this, or it computes, that's the word I was looking for, computes Fibonacci at compile time. And Fibonacci takes quite a while to calculate when it is when you're calculating Fibonacci of 50. Okay, so in our little simulated setup, we had Fibonacci.h that was included by both G and H. Those files, the G file, was a DF, whatever, took a long time to compile. But imagine that I wanted to change something in the Fibonacci file, and I didn't want to see my compiler go off and recompile 8 or 16 or how many files it could compile at a time, just to wait for the last slowest file to be complete before it could tell me, oh yeah, you still have a tiny little thing that you need to change. For that, it would be okay if I was just compiling the fastest of those files, fixing up that whole thing. When I was done, I would compile the next file, fix up everything in there, and so on. Until I was certain that my header file was correct, and then I would be starting my make minus j or whatever build system I have to recompile everything. And that is the trick in this episode. I'll change something in here, so it's now called foo-bar-1, which will definitely make it recompile everything if I press build. Was it g or was it f? Let's see. Oh, over here in the CPP, G was the one that was fast to compile. So I'll go up here, build, and instead of cleaning everything, I will say build file g.cpp. And I better get into my fingers, Control Alt B. So Control Alt and B for build. There we are. That was pretty fast. And I could make another, I could make another change to my Fibonacci here. And I could, Control-Alt-B, and it would build. Pretty nifty. There is one catch. If you're not watching CMake, or if you're not using CMake, thank you for watching this episode of Qt Widgets and More. But if you're watching, if you're using CMake, please stay tuned. You're still here, I guess. That means that you are using CMake as the backend instead of QMake, as I was up until now. See, there is a bug in Qt Creator with CMake as the backend for compiling stuff. Namely that if you have selected the checkbox, which I certainly hope that you have, saying save everything before compiling, then it will ignore that and it will not save everything when you build with CMake as a backend. Let me show you. But before I do that, let's go and download a tiny little script. So the script is from GitHub in KD Toolbox. It's KDAB's toolbox with lots of nifty little things. Let me just scroll down here and, well, go to that URL yourself and read through all of those different tools that are in there. One of the tools that are in there is actually a tool for getting the initial CMake file. So I download it here, I run CMake minus project, and voila, in my Qt creator, I can now open a CMake list.txt file. And well, now I have Fibonacci both. This is the Qt version. Let's just throw that one away, close project. And here you can see this is the generated CMake. It's just like QMake minus project, but this time CMake minus project. Let me build it. And yes, we need to wait a bit for the big file to compile again. But while we're waiting for that, let's just go and find Fibonacci in here. Fibonacci.h. And of course, Fibonacci should be spelled with a capital F. I don't know why, but it should. So there we are, spelled with a capital F. I'll go over here and I'll just check my stuff. So compiling, just G, Control, Alt, B for build, Control, Shift, B. No, that was not it. So let's go and check it out. Build just this one file. Where are you? Oh, it's in the header file. Bummer. Build just this one file is for C++ files. And of course I made that mistake just to show it. And I of course also made the mistake that I now actually, I kind of built everything when I was searching for the shortcut, but now I've changed it back to low caps lock. Who invented caps lock? Into lowercase Fibonacci. So I fix the bug, I go over to my g.cpp and Control Alt B for build. Fibonacci was not declared in the scope. That's peculiar. Let me see. Fibonacci. It is. And this is the until it comes to the realization. Oh, it didn't save the file, which is the bug. Please do upvote the bug report below so we can get this bug fixed. Did you know, by the way, that Fibonacci numbers, I'm sure you knew, is modeled, one of the models for them is how rabbits multiply. And here's the trivial fact for you to like. I have, well, technically it's my daughter's, but I have rabbits. I have two of them running around in my office all day long. If I get 30 thumbs up on this video, I will take one of them and show them in an upcoming video. How about that? Until then, have a good time. I'm Jesper Pedersen, and you've been watching Qt Widgets and More.